Thank you, Mr. Speaker and members. I want to begin by saying hey to all the mighty citizens that are here with us in the gallery and out in the rotunda, and to thank Representative Doubt for such a respectful debate, and to the members in the House today for what has been a really heartfelt conversation. I also want to thank Representative Clark for all her work on this for so many years in bringing us to this point. Minnesotans have been on a journey for some time now, engaged in a conversation granting same-sex couples the freedom to marry the person who they love. The conversation is rooted deeply in personally held beliefs about the institution we cherish, marriage. And today, specifically, we're talking about civil marriage. People have considered this issue and what it means for Minnesotans, and I have been, I will tell you, a witness to some of the best of Minnesota. And while we haven't all agreed and we haven't always started in the same place, we have listened to each other respectfully, conversation by conversation, Minnesotan to Minnesotan. I have an excerpt from a letter from one Minnesotan who lives in the district I represent, and he gave me permission to read just this little part to you. His name is Philip Higgs, and he asked, I'm asking you to help ensure that all Minnesotans are treated equally under the law. Minnesota is my home. I went to college here. I shared my first kiss here. I learned to love coffee shops here, and I became an adult here. I've fallen in love here, and I want the opportunity to get married here. When I moved to Minnesota, it was the first time I had felt free to be myself since I was a child. For the first time in my life, being gay was just a facet of myself and not my defining characteristic. It's time that we Minnesotans, all of us, are recognized for our commitment to equality, our strength of character, and our sense of fairness. Since I was 18, he says, I have believed that Minnesota is a place where dreams can come true. It's been these conversations, these personal experiences, these stories of love and home that have guided us to this point today. I remember as a little girl playing with my mom's veil. I remembered that it was really lovely and sparkly when she let me put it on, which was rare because she didn't want me to mess it up. And even as a young girl, I knew it represented something more than something pretty to put on my head, that it represented the marriage between my parents. And something at that age, even at 5 and 6 years old, I already knew that that marriage represented something important in our society, and it was something that I hoped for myself one day. And as an adult, I was free to make that choice, and I did. And I'm not going to bore you with the details of me and Joe Faust or embarrass my beautiful daughters. Instead, I will tell you a story about something that hasn't happened yet. It's a story that's going to happen 5 years, 10 years, 20 years from now, and it'll happen time and time again for many Minnesotans. It's a story about a coworker. It's a story about your best friend. It's a story about your son, your daughter, or your grandchild. Let's say it's a story about Frances. You haven't seen Frances in a while. She gives you a call, and she wants to meet you in a coffee shop. You arrive first at the coffee shop, wondering what news Frances will share. Maybe something's wrong. But when she bounds through the door, she's beaming from ear to ear, and you know she's here to share good news. She can barely sit down before she blurts out, "I've found someone special. I think I've found the person I want to spend the rest of my life with, and I really want to know what you think." And I think to myself, well, that's really big news. I want to ask Frances some questions. So I begin. "Do you make each other laugh?" And she says, "Every day, and we're best friends." And I think, okay. So another question. "Do you pick each other up when you're feeling down?" And she says, "Yes, we bring out the best in one another." And then I ask the hard question, "Do you really love each other?" And without hesitation, Frances says, "Yes, deeply and completely." And with that, I smile, knowing because that's the only question that needs to be asked. This is Minnesota, and everyone in Minnesota has the freedom to marry the person they love. That is the Minnesota I love, and with love, I'll vote yes. Thank you.